take it. All right, copy. Yeah, sure. Oh, look at that. Woo, it's falling apart. All right, copy. Copy. I don't know if you can hear me. I don't know why I can't. I hear you. Whoa! Yeah, it is, Rick, and we've seen some bigger pieces that, besides that little small piece, just slide in. Now, this is going to be the MetroLink, and this is what it's supposed to look like right there, and this is what it looks like right now. That gravel being undermined by this moving water, you can see it just kind of making its way across Soledad Canyon right there, making its own little pathway over to the riverbed. Now, this is undermining the railway area. You can see the MetroLink stopped right there. That's going to be a southbound train, but that train actually has people on it. You'd be thinking people would be going north trying to get home, but this is actually a train full of people heading back to the valley. Now, it's unclear what MetroLink is going to do. I'm sure the conductor, that's those people right there with the orange vest, they're probably not going to chance driving across this right now, especially with this being undermined. So this means that the MetroLink definitely going to have some sort of delays out here. Many times we'll see what they do is they'll bring out buses, they'll get those people onto those buses, but you also got to think, how are they going to get to the bus with all that water? Right now, though, just panning down along the way, that was just one small section of railway that was is beginning to be undermined right there. You can see where a lot of it has been washed away into the Santa Clarita River. So this is going to be something that the MetroLink engineers are going to have to get out here. They're going to have to inspect it and make sure that it's safe for that train to pass. Right now, though, they're erring on the side of caution, as they should, and that train stopped. But even if they decide to get those folks off that train, it's probably going to be a little bit of a walk to get to them some buses. And they probably can do it up here. Nope, they can't. So I'm just trying to looking around to see if there's a way where they can get from the railroad to the roadway without getting wet or muddy. But right now, it seems to be the only thing they're going to do is wait on that train. And, of course, they're going to get people out here to make that decision if it's safe for the train to pass. And if not, then they're going to have to get all those people off and get them onto buses to a place where they can meet again with the MetroLink. Right now, though, the water's still rushing in this railroad area. We see some big chunks falling into the water, but not right up to the railway. But still, with that heavy train, they don't want to take any chances. Rick? No, I think, yeah, you can see that line that's like that. It looks like a wire. That line is actually like a spot where it's thicker. I want to check something else, though. I know they want to stay on that shot, but I see something else. When I told you that story about my Suburban, that's where it happened, right there. Oh, no. Oh, no, it was right here. I was going to say, it didn't look right. It was right there. All right, hang on. I know where there's some damage. I want to go find some damage. Where was that fence that came down? No, I thought it was over here. Maybe it was farther up. There it is. There it is. There it is. There it is. Oh, I'm shooting behind us? All right. Yeah, there you go. Thank you. Okay. Hey, there's a pursuit in 21. It's down in the valley, a chase. Launch the second chopper. Certified. I know, I'm listening to it, Courtney.